Hi guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. This is Sai Sangmalyana. First of all, I want to clear you one thing. What exactly is counseling? So counseling is nothing but like selecting your preferences and scrutinizing all the options and giving the allotment, and after accepting the allotment, paying the fees and getting provisional admission letter. So all this comes under counseling. Don't think that counseling means one-on-one interview like that. So it is nothing like that. All these processes comes under counseling, and we call it as counseling for admission. So that is what I wanted to clear. So because many people are asking me related to that, brother, will there be any interview between me and any other teacher? So nothing like that. Now coming to payment of 1,10,000 or 10,000 according to your dashboard. So it is extended till 11 PM 3rd June. That is today till night 11 PM. You have time to pay that particular amount. There you will be having display amount to be paid. So that will be somewhere, for some people it is 1,10,000, for some people it is 10,000, for some people it is 0, okay? So based on that you need to payment. So for those who got 0, just accept the seat, nothing, no more to do, because you need not to pay anything. But for those who need to pay 10,000, accept the seat, and there you will be finding the account details. There you need to send NEFT or RTGS. So if you have online banking, you can do it NEFT. So if you don't know anything, you can go to your bank and you can complete for those who need to pay 1,10,000 or 10,000. And keep in your mind that 10,000 is not refundable or non-transferable. So 1 lakh is adjusted later in your tuition fee, and if you don't join, it may be refundable to you within next 6 months. Okay, so that refund policies will be updated soon on the website. Now coming to provisional admission letter, it will be given to you soon. So don't worry, you will get it soon. Okay.
An Academy IIT JEE comeback test series once again back. India's biggest weekly scholarship test for IIT JEE aspirants. You can enroll now for free using the, you can register now for free using my code CHARINYT, CHARINYT. Do check it out.
Microbatch JEE Main and Advanced 2023 batch is starting from 9th June. So these are the faculty who are going to teach them. If you are really interested in this particular batch, so link for this particular micro batch is in the description. Don't forget to use my code CHARINYT. So you'll get flat 10% discount on each and every subscription on An Academy. And at present, the bumper offer is going on in An Academy. If you buy for 12 months, you'll get 2 months subscription free till JEE 2022. And if you buy 24 months subscription, you will get 3 months free subscription till JEE 2023. Now coming to scholarship. So there is a lot of changes in the ranks of the cutoffs regarding the scholarship. Previous year, below 2500, they gave scholarship, 100% scholarship. But this year, only below 500 students are getting the scholarship. So the reason behind and the logic behind this particular thing, I will be explaining as we move forward in this video. And so regarding scholarship, 1-100 rank, if you get 100% tuition fee waiver and 100% hostel, mess, everything total, nothing in first year, okay? So now 101 to 500 only tuition fee waiver, mess and hostel should be paid for first year. And those who got admission through your place too, if PCM is above 98%, all things, so 100% tuition fee waiver, 100% mess, hostel, everything 100%. If you are day scholar, transport fee is also 100%. Now PCM above 95%, for them only 100% tuition fee waiver, mess, transport or hostel, so that is up to you, you need to pay. And coming to children of defense personnel, for them 25% tuition fee waiver, okay? Now coming to this particular thing, this scholarship's only valid for your first year. So once you complete your first year, so your scholarship depends on the CGPA you scored in the first year. So if you want to continue with your scholarship, do study properly and get very good CGPA there. And the CGPA cutoffs, everything will be mentioned to you later as you once you join the college, okay? Now coming to cutoffs. Cutoffs or allotment, I wanted to talk much about it because so many students got no allotment and the paper showed blank. So as I thought, for results also for some time it showed totally blank, and later it got updated. As I thought, the same thing is going to happen for this, but that is not correct one. So what exactly happened is, some student got 1100 rank, he chose CSE with AI and ML. So he didn't got the allotment because even though he has a good rank, he didn't got allotment. But according to last year cutoffs, he should get the allotment. So in the first round, what happened, many people didn't got allotment. So don't worry, you will get allotment in the second round. And now coming to second round, it is going to happen on 4th June. Okay, so that is from tomorrow. So you need to once again either choose the same option or you want to change option. That is up to you. So you need to, so that you need to understand, because even I can't predict the cutoff this year. Okay, so one thing I wanted to say, why the cutoffs have changed drastically is, only one thing I can say is, last year by the time of SRM counseling, some students got splitted, like they have chosen various private universities and some other counselings are already happened. But this year SRM is the first one to conduct the counseling. So due to that, students don't have any other choice and many students have inclined towards SRM. So this is one of the reason what I think. So that may be correct or not. Coming to choice. So many people are asking, brother, whether to choose CSE core or CSE with specialization. Coming to CSE with specialization, you will be having an extra course under your belt. So that is under your resume, you can add your extra course. For example, if you took AI and ML with CSE, so you can add like CS with specialization in AI and ML. So you would be having a somewhat good opportunities when compared to a CSE student. But mostly what I would suggest you is, so even if you study any specialization, so there won't be much difference according to me, because even if you study with any specialization, you can sit under CSE placements. So mostly most of the students will come to again CSE placements only. So that's what I wanted. I hope you got what I wanted to convey. So now coming to major drawbacks of this particular counseling, like what I observed from this SRMJE counseling is, asking students to choose only one option is really not a good thing actually, because how students can come to know that with their particular rank they can get so and so particular seat for sure. So they would have allowed you to keep at least 4 to 5 options, like in a preference order. First on this, if that is not possible, the next one. If that is not possible, the next one. If that is not possible, the next one. So the probability of allotment would be more when compared to the present situation. So I don't know why they have kept only one choice, but no issues. You have another second round, right? So wait for that. I hope everyone gets what you deserve. Yeah. Now coming to one more important thing about SRMJE counseling, which I personally didn't like, is no proper timings. So they release the results on their own time. They release everything on their own time. So they will not inform the even students. So even if they inform through mail, some get mails, some don't get any mail. So this is what I observed, one mistake from SRM. So if anyone watching from SRM, please do change these things from the next thing, because many students are getting into dilemma and they are literally got confused, and some people even cried calling to me, brother, these things are happening, what we have to do. And now coming to nothing properly mentioned in their website. So you, like as a reputed university, you should mention everything in your website properly. Coming to refund policies, that is most important thing. So you mentioned that if the students joins the institute, that will be adjusted in the tuition fee. But what if a student doesn't join your university? So what you will do? So that thing you need to mention, right? So you missed that one. And so that is what I'm saying. These are some things which I observed and which I personally didn't like at any cost, because these things made many students fall under confusion, and some people are even like very much depressed regarding to particular things. So that's all for this video. If you find this as a time worthy video, please do like, share and subscribe. See you in the next one. Until then, take care. Bye bye. Jai Hind.